This is Tay. She's currently taking biomedical engineering in University of Malaya. She loves to jog around UM to fill in her leisure time. One last finding.
Hello, this is emergency number. What can I help you?
My ankle sprained and I need help.
Okay, we'll be there in a minute.
Don't worry, we will help you to the stretcher. So today we will learn how to find stress, torsion and deformation of the object. So we'll be taking the rod as our calculation. Let's just assume that all the informations of the rod, which is the length, the radius, the energy loadings. And as we assume that the rod is a metal, so the Young's modulus is 191 gigapascal. So after we have all the information, we can start calculating. First, I will calculate the stress of the object using the formula rho equals to P over A. So for your information, rho indicates the stress, P indicates the energy loading, or the force of the object, and A is the area of the object. Here, we use pi r square indicates the area of a circle. Here, the conversion of unit is very important as it affects the final answer. So you must be very careful. Yes, you must be very careful when you are calculating the area. Now we have the values of the force and the area of the rod, so we just substitute all that into the formula and we get 74.272 kilopascal. Second thing we want to find is the torsion. As you can see at the free body diagram above, there's F, which is force acting upward, and there's 500 newton, which is the load that is acting downward, and the informations of the rod. As you can see, the shear stress formula, which is Tc over J. Tau indicates the shear stress, T indicates the torsion, C indicates the radius, and J indicates the polar moment of inertia. As the rod shaped cylinder, so the formula of J is pi over 2c4, and when you substitute the value of R, you get the 1.2723 times 10 to the power of negative 6 m4. So using different formula of tau, which is F over A, F we get is 250, and area that is calculated earlier, so we can get 88 over 433 kilopascal. So if we rearrange the first formula, we can get T equals to tau J over C, and when we substitute all the values, we get the torsion, which is 3.7506 newton meter. Last but not least, we want to find the deformation of the rod, assuming that the rod is a metal, so the Young's modulus is 191 gigapascal. Okay, for the formula, deformation equals to PL over AE. P is the force applied, L is the length, A is the area of the rod which we have calculated earlier, and E is the Young's modulus of the rod. So when we substitute all the informations, we get 6.223 times 10 to the power of negative 7 meter. Yeah!